Welcome to the tutorial on how to use the one-on-one meeting Google Sheets template. If you don't have a copy of this template, no worries. I will include links in the video description where you can go ahead and purchase it. For this walkthrough, I'll be demonstrating with a demo version of this template. I'll show you step by step how to get the most of all of the features and functionalities of the template. Before I switch over to the demo copy of this template, I do want to point out that there is an instructions tab included in your template that contains all of my contact information, as well as a complete step-by-step guide that you can refer to while you're using this template. We are in the demo copy of this template, and the first tab we're going to review is the setup tab, and this is pretty straightforward. This is where you would add or edit the different categories for your meetings that will allow you to visualize the data in your dashboard. The only thing I need to point out is that you should be able to change all of the statuses here and add whatever status that you want. The only option that you will not be able to edit, meaning that if you do try to edit the cell, you will receive a warning telling you not to change it. And this is because this allows some of the functionalities in the dashboard to work properly. All right, so the next tab is the meetings tab. And when you open your actual template, this would be blank. This is what it would look like when you purchase this template. It is completely blank. None of the dates are activated except for the first one. And you do have placeholders to show you where the meeting title would go, as well as the meeting objective. So this is what it's going to look like when you open the tab. And here's what it looks like when it has information in it. The meetings tab contains a total of 52 meetings. As you can see, it is numbered from 1 all the way through 52. Before we get into the details of the meetings tab, just a quick overview. This part right here contains a link that takes you directly to the dashboard tab, which is where you would see a summary of all of the meetings. Going back here, here is a little header area, one for the date, one for the meeting title, and the last one for the meeting objective. And these areas would allow you search the template for specific meetings. Because we have a long list of meetings in one specific sheet, this would allow us to quickly identify a specific meeting without having to dig through 52 different meetings. So for example, if I wanted to identify this meeting number 11 that took place Friday, May 10, 2024, all I have to do is double click and select a date using the date picker option, Friday, May 10th. And as you can see, it highlights that meeting and I can go ahead and expand that meeting and view the contents of that meeting. We can do the same thing using the meeting title as well as the meeting objective. So if I were to delete this, it goes back to normal. And let's make this meeting title more specific. All right, so now that we have a more specific name for this meeting, what we can do is actually copy this name, okay, and search for it here. And just like we saw with the meeting date, it will highlight the specific cell that has a match with that name, and you can easily identify the meeting that way. The same works with the meeting objective. If there is more than one meeting with the exact same name, it would highlight all of them. So if I were to add this meeting title to this cell, for example, you can see that both of these cells would be highlighted. But if I were to delete this and change this to May 10th, you can see only this meeting is highlighted. And if I were to select May 24th, it changes to this one. So this area acts like a search bar. It allows you to quickly identify a meeting that you need to, because it's very easy to scroll through 1 through 52 when all of the tabs are collapsed, and you can identify the meeting that you need to and open up the tab to view the contents of that meeting. All right, so the next would be to show you exactly how this works. Like I said before, we have a total of 52 collapsed tabs that will be used for the meetings, meaning that you can use this template in one sheet for 52 different meetings. To start using this template, you would open up the tab by clicking on this plus sign right here. So once I click on this, it opens up the meeting template. In a meeting template, you can add the meeting date, the meeting title, the meeting objective, and the start time, the end time. To add the start time and end time, you do have to add AM or PM to the time. So if I were to delete this time and type 9 and enter, it does not work. And this is because it doesn't have AM or PM. So if I were to change this to 9 AM, you can see it converts it to the correct time format. If I wanted to type 9, it would be the same. It would be 9:30 enter, and then it comes up just like this in the correct format. And this correct format is necessary for this part of the formula to work, as well as for the time to show up correctly in the dashboard area. The next area is where you would add some priority items that you would like to discuss during the meeting, and you have the space underneath there for some pre-meeting notes. Here is where you will add your agenda items, and you can cross this off as you go through the different agenda items during the meeting. Down here is where you would add your action items, and you can add up to 12 action items as well. You can add the date for the deadline as well as the status. And you have the option of changing the differences here by going to the setup tab and adding a different status. So let's say I change this to status 13 and hit enter. If I were to go back to the meeting, you can see I'm able to select additional status 13. So if you want to change this, don't click this. Go ahead and go to the setup tab to change the different statuses. All right, the next area is the meeting notes area, and this is where you would type up all of the notes that you have for that meeting. This space is enough to contain two lines of text. So if I were to add some sample text here, you can see that we have 1-2 lines of text. This does have more than 2 lines of text. So what you can do is, if you have a lot of information, you can just remove that and use the next row for your additional text. And here we have 2 more lines of text, and we could remove the last one and add it here. If you feel like you need a little bit more space, you can scroll all the way to the end of the template and then expand this a little bit to give you a little bit more room for your text. If you don't need as much space for your text, you can also shorten this space so that you have more of the template showing up on your screen. Once you are done with this, you can go ahead and collapse it and move on to the next meeting area. The other thing I want to point out is that this area is gray and this area is colored, and this is intentionally designed. What this template automatically does is that it grays out all of your meetings in the past so that you can focus on the meetings in your future. If I were to remove the dates in the future, for example, by deleting it, it also grays it out. That way you have a clean slate and you can easily identify meetings that are in the past and meetings that are in the future. For example, if I were to change this date in March to something in the future by clicking on it and selecting a date, let's say in May, you can see that it changes the color. That way you can easily see the meetings that have passed and the meetings that are in future. The way this ideally would work is that all of these would be empty, and as you go through each individual meeting, you would go ahead and add a new date for your meeting, and then the color would change. And when this date moves over to the past, it grays out just like the rest of them. That way your template is clutter-free and easier to navigate. The other thing I wanted to point out is, if you wanted to view all of the meetings at once, all you would need to do is go over to this area. Instead of clicking the plus to expand one meeting, right-click and select expand all row groups. When you do this, you can see that we have all of the meetings showing up, and you can just scroll through to visualize all of the meetings. And if you wanted to collapse it all at once, you would do the same thing. Go to that area all the way at the end of the left side of the screen, right click, collapse all row groups, and you're able to collapse everything. The next part is the dashboard, and this allows you to visualize information as well as navigate to your different meetings. The dashboard area comprises of 4 parts. Here we have a search box where we can input a date, and we can see the meeting title tied to that date as well as the meeting objective. We also have an area here where we can actually filter the action items tied to a specific meeting. So from all of the 52 meetings, we have 16 action items that are not started. We have 18 items in progress, and we have 17 items completed. If I were to go back to no filter, you can see we have 1 item with this status, 16 with not started, 18 with in progress, and 17 incompleted. And this shows us all of the action items for this entire range. So Friday, March 1st, 2024 to Saturday, March 8th, 2025. So ideally, the way you would use this would be to see, what are my outstanding action items that I have either for one meeting or maybe for the month of May. Let's go ahead and change this date to May 31st, 2024. So now we have 1 month of information. So within this month, we have 2 action items in progress, 2 not started, and 1 completed. And if you were to scroll down, you can see the specific action items that under status is next to it. So you can see we have 2 in progress, 2 not started, so 12 and 14 not started, and 1 completed. That way you can actually visualize specifically the number of action items and the actual action items that you have not completed for that meeting period. The next table area is the meeting summary area. The first column contains the meeting number as well as a link. So if I were to hover around it, you would see a link. And if I click on this link, it takes me directly to that meeting in the meetings tab. So let's go to meeting number 31, hover around it, the link to that meeting shows up. And if I click on that, it takes me directly to meeting number 31. And of course, you're welcome to click on the dashboard to go back to the dashboard area. So this area allows us to quickly navigate to specific meetings in the meeting tab, as well as gives us some more information about that meeting. So you can see that for meeting 1, it took place March 1st. I started at 9:30 and the meeting lasted for 30 minutes. And if we wanted to see more about meeting 1 without having to navigate, we can say, okay, meeting 1 was March 1st. Let's select March 1st here. And once you do that, you can see that for March 1st, this was the meeting title. This was the meeting objective. And we can change the dates here to March 1st and the end dates to March 1st. And now all of the information displayed here is related to the meeting in March 1st. So for meeting March 1st, we have the meeting title, the meeting objective. We can see for March 1st, we only have 1 action item, and that action item has this additional status. So let's put in some information so it makes more sense how this would work. So let's go to meeting number 1, and then let's add some action items. I'm just going to add some random action items here. So for March 1st, this is the meeting title here, and meeting objective, I'll just add March 1st so it's easy to identify. And here we have 7 action items, and I'm going to add some deadlines to these, and I will update the status. So do not started, we'll put a couple of them in progress, and the last 2 would say are completed. All right, so let's assume the meeting notes area for March 1st has been completed and navigate back to the dashboard. So when we go here, you can see that for March 1st, this is the meeting title. Remember, we changed the meeting title. This is what it is, the meeting objective for March 1st. You can see that for March 1st, we have the 7 action items, right? And here is a summary of the status. We have 7 of them, 2 not started, 3 in progress, and 2 completed. And if you were to go down here, you can see all of the action items, the specific action items listed here, and you can see the individual status right next to it. And if we were to change this to, for example, you can see that when we go back here, it changes to 2 hours because the meeting started at 8 o'clock and ended at 10 o'clock. That way, when you have a meeting and you have specific things that you want to remember, you can easily go back here and keep track of that information. So with the date of the meeting, you should be able to put that information directly here. You will be able to see the meeting title, the meeting objectives, the action items tied to that meeting dates, as well as the specific action items and their statuses. All right, so that brings me to the end of this demo video. I hope this was helpful. If you do have any questions, please feel free to contact me. All of my contact information is available here. And again, feel free to refer to this step-by-step guide that has some more information that would help you use this template and answer some of the frequently asked questions that might come up. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.